season 5 of Black Mirror. Well, it's been kind of shitty. We had the Miley Cyrus docudrama, some gay prawn thing, and Smithereens. Chris holds a man at gunpoint, wanting to talk to Billy, the CEO of Not Twitter. He's angry that Not Twitter is addictive, and in his past killed his girl when he looked away from the road for a split second.
And it was boring. I got bored. Got bored every 10 seconds back then, I think. And I'm on this A road. It was very quiet, straight. On my phone lights up, and I check it. I was just glance at it, you know. It was just a little notification thing saying someone liked the comment that I made about some photo in theirs. I just glanced at it, you know. That's all the time it took.
The auto accident in 2015.
He lost his fiance in that crash. Were you aware of that?
No. But you are.
But there were historical posts from inside his network.
Condolences, memorials, and that's when Chris disengages, in fact, not interacting with friends,
even those expressing grief.
You've done your homework.
Chris is looking to blame someone. He has to. He can't face himself for what he's done. In this modern world, addiction is treated like a disease. Almost like we have no control over our actions.
I was stupid one night and drank too much and then drove a car. That was dumb and I'm not gonna do it again.
Randy, you are powerless to make that decision. The only thing that works is the 12-step program. Step 1 is admitting that you are powerless to control your drinking. Only then can you move on to the other 12 steps, like believing that only a higher power, God, makes you stop drinking, and then turning your life over to that God and humbly asking God to remove your weaknesses.
Wait, hold on. I never knew that Alcoholics Anonymous was a religious thing.
It's not religious. You just have to admit that there is some kind of God which has power over you and turn your life over to that God and ask him for forgiveness. That's the 12-step program, not religion.
Look, I really just need to cut down on my drinking and never drive a car drunk again.
You can't just cut down on your drinking, Randy. You need to know something. You have a disease.
A disease?
That's right. Alcoholism is a disease. You're sick, Randy. You're very, very sick. And just like with most diseases, you can't cure it yourself. And it's deadly.
Oh my God.
Sure, it's not your fault you have an addiction, but it is your responsibility.
It's not your fault, but you're part of it, okay?
You're scared of failure. Walk a mile in my shoes, and then we'll talk. I failed before, in business.
When?
When I opened a restaurant in my hometown thinking I was the dog's bollocks. And it made me the person I am today, having both success and failure. Don't be scared. You can't keep on sidestepping problems.
This attitude, that addictions are the fault of the manufacturer, infantilizes people. We're all adults, and adults should have the right to be stupid.
Stan!
Aw, goddammit!
Stan, I need your help.
Dad, what are you doing in Grandpa's extra wheelchair?
I've gotta try to take it easy from now on, son. Get Daddy another beer, will ya?
No, you don't need another beer! Dad, you just need to not drink so much. It's very simple.
I wish it was that simple, son. But if I don't give myself up to a higher power, then this disease is gonna kill me dead. I'm afraid the only thing that will cure me is a miracle.
We shouldn't blame anyone for our own actions. Yes, Twitter is specifically designed to be addictive. But so is alcohol, and cigarettes, and slots. If you get in debt to the Russian mafia and get your legs broken, that's not the fault of the guy who invented the fruit machine.
You rack a discipline!
Nuh-uh, I don't rack a discipline! Excuse me, who's in charge here?
None of us are in charge. We're all powerless.
We sure
That's
are.
That's right.
Uh-huh. Look, my dad was here yesterday, and you all kind of messed him up by telling him he had a disease.
Alcoholism is a disease.
No, it's not. And you can't just go around saying stuff like that to people like my dad. He's kind of a hypochondriac.
It is a disease because it's a physical dependency. That makes it a disease.
No, cancer is a disease. My dad needs to drink less.
He can't quit by himself. None of us could. He needs divine intervention, spirituality.
No, he just needs a discipline. But thanks to you people, my dad now thinks he has a disease that he can't cure himself.
Young man, do you know anything about the 12-step program?
Yeah, and I also know a thing or two about cults. I was the leader of one for a while. God damn it.
The modern world infantilizes people, just as YouTube infantilizes language. Oh, golly gee, Mr. YouTube. Please don't hit me with that big old demonetization stick. You're an adult, Chris. Take responsibility. Own up to it. That doesn't mean denying yourself.
Dad, stop!
I'm sorry, son. I'm off the wagon.
Dad, you don't have to do this. You have the power. You know, Stan, I'd say that your dad racks a discipline. All or nothing is easy. But learning to drink a little bit, responsibly, that's a discipline. Discipline come from within.
I'm so sorry to interrupt, but there's a situation you need to know about.
Like Billy, going off on text detox out in the middle of bumfuck nowhere. That's not a discipline. Addiction is not your fault, but it is your responsibility. Not Mr. Not Twitter Sue. Not God. You. So take responsibility and get some bollocks.
I want you all to take a good look at Stan's dad and say, is that who I want to be in 30 years? Getting tickets and having to go to elementary school classrooms and talk about how pathetic I am? Thank you, Mr. Marsh. I think you made your point.
Minasan, you all need more discipline. True discipline come from within. We're out of time. I will see you on Tuesday. Chirup!
We should sell nothing else tonight except products.